Hey, what's up, you guys? I'm sorry I've been away for a while, but I figured now would be a good time to make a video because the Mint playing cards, one of my favorite decks, are now live for their second edition on Kickstarter. This is a very nice deck of cards, and this is not the second edition, this is the launch edition, as you can see. And this particular deck is actually now a collectible. It's sought after by lots of magicians after it went out of stock last year, about a year and a half ago. Or wait, no. Yeah, about a year and a half ago it went out of stock. And I managed to get my hands on two Raspberry decks. I hadn't thought much of these decks. I'd only seen pictures of them, and I was like, yeah, whatever, they look pretty plain, but they came highly recommended by lots of other magicians who I was seeing them used by. And I was thinking, wow, that's pretty cool. So I've decided to pick up a deck, and I really liked it, and I was able to pick up another one before they went out of stock. So, anyway, the only major differences between the launch editions and the second editions is that they're introducing some new colors, or flavors as they refer to them. This is the raspberry deck, so they're introducing a blueberry deck, which is an interesting shade of blue, a frost deck, which is white and gold, and that's a limited edition one. It's completely borderless as opposed to the standard bordered ones, but these are still really nice. And the first limited edition one was a gold and black one. The launch edition ones had gold and raspberry, and if things work out well for the second edition mint decks, which I'm sure they will, they are also going to be introducing a cucumber deck, which is their green line. So that's pretty cool. Anyway, basically anything that you see from this deck, you're gonna be able to expect from the next one, and they're supposed to have made some improvements. I recommend you go and watch 52 Cards, Cards' presentation of their second edition mint deck for an advertisement for the Kickstarter. But this is on Crushed Bicycle Stock, as the next one's gotta be, and it has some very nice finish. They come with two gimmick cards, a double backer and a double facer. And the deck itself is marked. It's gonna be, they're supposed to have made some major improvements to the marking system. It's gonna be the same marking system, but it's gonna be easier to read and easier to use because this is, but I do really like how subtle this marking system is. I'm not gonna go into that because it's gonna take like 15 minutes all in itself, but just go to 52cards.com. They have a whole section on the mint deck and everything about it, and you can look at the marking system there. And this review is from the perspective of someone who's been using the deck for the last year and a half, so you're gonna be getting some pretty cool insight into the deck itself. And as you can see, this deck is very well used. It's not the cleanest on the sides, but I do have another sealed deck, but I don't want to open it because it's worth $85. So, yeah. Anyway, so everything to say about this deck is good, and it can be used for pretty much anything. Shuffles are really amazing with it, except this surface isn't down. It's just a piece of fabric that I got from German Fabrics. Sorry, my dogs are going nuts. So yeah, it shuffles really well. It's traditionally cut, so you can do the Pharaoh Shuffle and Giant Fans with it. Let's see if I can do a Pharaoh Shuffle again. This edge is somewhat old, so it's not the best. So yeah, you got that. You can do flourishes of all kinds. You can use it for cardistry, card tricks, techniques. You can use it for cheating techniques if you're into that sort of thing. You know, sometimes you can do cheating techniques for card tricks. You know, just deal a second card down. That was bad, but anyway, you can deal a second card. And it's thin stock, but it's still nice and springy and tough, so you can do stuff like that. Yikes. Like that. You can do special flourishes like the hot shot. Like that. Hey, I've sort of degraded in catching cards. I've sort of been focusing on trying to catch it with my mouth. I haven't been practicing catching cards all that much. Let's see if I can do that. There we go. That's better. And the stock will last you for a long time because it's on crushed B stock, so that's very nice. The finish is something special. It says that it's standard air cushion finish, but I think that they've added something to it. I don't know. But point being, it looks really nice with fans. Back design itself is a very, very nice repeating pattern back design, and I just really like it. The cut is completely even, I'd say. I mean, I've not come across a deck of cards that's even like this one is. So, with this deck, About everything about it is customized. The faces are pretty standard, but they're still altered. I don't know if you can see, but it has like a silver lining around the pips, and the indexes are a little bit different too. All of the face cards are customized. This is not a standard face, and in the clothing, you can see the back design, which is pretty cool. And all of the aces are featured, which is to say that they're all pretty big and special, instead of like a little tiny ace, even though it's the best, one of the best cards. Like I said, I have an ace in my hat there, so yeah, it works out. And speaking of which, let's see if I can find the Ace of Spades. There it is. It has a raspberry back design lining around it, and all of the various colors have that. With their own color. The box, I won't spend too much time on the box, but it's still cool enough to mention. It seems to be like just regular cardboard, and it's very nice. I don't know what finish it has on it, but it's just a very simple feel to it, with some silver foil there. The inside is like that. That's really cool. A customized sticker, launch edition. It's probably going to say second edition with the next ones. I don't know everything about the second edition ones yet, but I'm gonna get one and make a review as soon as they come out. So, but they are on Kickstarter, so just go over to kickstarter.com/mint, and you can donate any amount of money you want to and get yourself a deck come whenever they're out and cranking them out. Back design again, and the mint collection on the side there, so that's pretty cool. As for handling of all types, you can, this deck is about, it's going on 2 years old, so it's, and it's still handling really, really well after lots of use. I have been using this deck for lots and lots of performances, so it does show the fans aren't quite as smooth as they were. But it's still working really well. Double lifts and fans aren't quite as smooth as they were, but they still work very well. And again, constant use for the last year and a half to 2 years. I don't know exactly how long, I should know. But you can do tons of stuff with that. And let's see if I can do this one flourish. I've been curious to see if you can do this one flourish with an old deck of cards. So, oops, I just ferried it the wrong way. If it's traditionally cut, you do it the other way. So let's see. This probably won't work, but it's worth a try. Okay, so that was surprisingly good. As for maneuvers, I have used this deck for performance with tons and pretty much every different maneuver I know, anything from the double lift to the pass to color changes, and it works just fine. And spreads are excellent with it. You can do shuffling, you can do dealing, and, you don't want to play it with card games because it's marked. But you could do that, I suppose. It would work quite well. If you wanted to cheat at cards, this would be the deck to use. I'm just kidding. Don't believe me. Well, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, but point being, I really, really like this deck, and I would recommend that you get it as soon as you come out. Or if you want to pay $80-some for the original deck, then that's fine, too. And the borderless decks look really nice. I'm going to see if I can get my hands on them, but they are a bit more pricey, so I might not end up getting any of those. I have a couple of rarer decks, but I usually don't like to spend tons of money on decks of cards because it's just not something that... I figure that I can get really good decks of cards for less, really good decks of cards that I like just as much for less, so I don't usually spend $100 on a deck of cards. But, you know, exceptions must be made here and there, so you never know what'll happen. But, so overall, I personally recommend this deck for pretty much anything. It is in my top 5 favorite decks, and keep an eye out for my top 5 favorite decks review that I'll be making sometime soon. And thanks for watching this review. I'll see you next time.